Who does not like the rainy season? Especially when hot pakoras are being made at home. Today, Sunaina, her younger brother Sohan, who is 2 years younger than Sunaina, her father and mother all were at home. Dad was making his favorite potato onion pakoras. Sunaina's mouth was watering on seeing this. Meanwhile, Sohan came shouting, "Didi! Didi!" and pulled her beside the window.
"Sister, look at the lightning in the sky."
"Seems like it is going to rain very hard."
Suddenly, the electricity of the house went off.
"Hey, someone come with a torch and help me in the kitchen."
On hearing Dad's voice, Sohan and Sunaina went carefully towards the kitchen. Mother started lighting the torch, but it didn't start.
"Mother, show it to me."
Sunaina went out in the light and checked the torch.
"Its bulb looks absolutely fine. Let me check the battery."
As soon as Sunaina pulled out both the cells, she noticed that one of them was not installed properly.
"Hey, this cell is fixed upside down. Now, let's place it correctly and check."
Sohan was watching all this very carefully. As soon as she fixes the cell, the torch lighted.
"Hey, very good. You've turned it on."
"Yes, Dad. Its cells were placed in the wrong direction. Now I have fixed them properly. Yesterday, we did this experiment in the class."
"Well, come. Now you all sit inside and let me bring hot pakoras for everyone."
"Sister, please tell me how you have turned on the torch."
"Sohan, a torch is a device that is lighted up with the help of an electric cell. Just watch this torch carefully. What does it have?"
"It has a very small bulb fixed to it that is similar to the big bulb in the room. But a big bulb runs on electricity."
"Rightly said, Sohan. Electricity in that bulb passes through wires. These wires are inside or outside the ground or walls. In this torch, electricity comes through the power cell. The electric cell inside this produces electricity. We will learn more about it in the school tomorrow. Then I will teach you in detail about this."
"Sure, sister."
"Yes, sure."
Meanwhile, Dad brings hot pakoras and everyone eats them with great fervor. The next day, while going to school, Sunaina had many questions in her mind.
"The electric switch has current. But where does this current come from? There are so many things in the house that run on the electricity. How do they all work?"
When Seema Didi came to class, Sunaina asked all these questions to her. Today, we are going to discuss about all of these, Sunaina. It's good that you asked this question. Let's do something interesting today, kids. Seema Didi made groups of 4 children and gave each group a bulb, some electric wires, plastic rubber, and an electric cell. All groups have a bulb, battery, and electric wires. First of all, check the bulb thoroughly and then tell me, what have you seen?
"The bulb is made up of glass and there are small wires inside the bulb."
"Those wires are called fibers. When we will light the bulbs by experiment, carefully inspect the fibers."
"The bottom of the bulb is made up of metal. It is round in shape." "Seema Didi, it also has a plus and a minus sign placed on it."
"That bulb has 2 terminals. One has a plus sign and one has a minus sign on it. Now we will all learn to turn on the bulb with the help of this battery. You should keep in mind that with the help of this battery, we are producing electricity.
Do this experiment in front of elders and only with the help of this battery. Do not repeat such experiments using electrical wire or socket. Now remove the plastic cover or layer from both ends of the electric cables.
All of you have been given a plastic rubber. With the help of that,
try to light the bulb by connecting the battery, wire and bulb.
All the five groups started working. Sunaina's group consists of Sunaina, Mohan, Meena and Pradeep. Sunaina quickly removes the plastic cover and Mohan puts the plastic rubber on the battery and starts connecting the other ends of the wires to different parts of the bulb. The same process is going on in other groups too.
Let me connect both these ends to the bottom of the bulb.
The bulb does not turn on while doing so.
Look at this! Marks are there, both on battery and bulb. Let's connect the plus sign of the cell with the plus sign of the bulb and the minus sign of the cell with the minus sign of the bulb.
On doing so, the bulb turns on.
Seema Didi, look, the bulb has turned on.
Oh wow, now let us connect it upside down.
Can we reverse this? Let's connect the plus sign of the cell with the minus sign of the bulb and the minus sign of the cell with the plus sign of the bulb.
Even on doing this, the bulb turns on. All the groups try to turn on the bulb in their own way and everyone succeeds. All the children were very happy after the experiment.
Seema Didi, why the bulb has turned on by only few methods?
Good question. Come, let's find out why has this happened. Sunaina,
how did the bulbs in your group turn on?
Didi, we connected the plus sign of the cell with the minus sign of the bulb with the help of a wire. This has caused our bulb to turn on.
When all the things, bulbs, wires and batteries are arranged properly,
then it makes a way for electricity to pass.
This type of arrangement, where both terminals of the power cell are connected to both terminals of the bulb, it is called an electric circuit. The bulb could only be turned on
when an electric current flows through the electric circuit you created.
Yes.
Okay, now let's make a flowchart of what we learned today, kids. Seema Didi created a flowchart on the board like this.
From electric cells, electricity is generated.
Electric current, which flows through electric circuit, through which electric devices operate. All the children made this diagram in their copies.
Today's class was very interesting. I will go home and tell about this to mother, father, and Sohan.
Sunaina was very happy today after doing the experiment on electricity in school. She was very eager to tell about this to everyone in home.
On reaching home, after washing her hands and mouth, she finished her lunch. She was eagerly waiting for her parents to return home from work.
As soon as mom and dad came back in the evening, Sunaina started telling them about her day.
Sohan also woke up after some time.
Mother, father, I wanted to tell you something.
Hey, Sunaina, let me sit first.
Sunaina and Sohan took the belongings from mother and father's hand and served them water.
Yes, Sunaina, now tell me, why are you so excited?
Dad, today at school we lighted a bulb with the help of batteries and wires.
Hey, wow, you must have enjoyed it a lot.
How did you do this, Sunaina Didi?
By making an electric circuit with the help of batteries and wires.
What is an electric circuit?
Sohan, to run any electrical device, an electric circuit is required, in which current flows. Bulb also lights because of this.
I also want to make electric circuit.
No, Sohan. Seema Didi guided us to make this at school. The material required to make it is not available at home.
Let me check in the old luggage box. I will surely find something in it. So Naina and Sohan became very happy. Mother brought an old box. Father and mother picked out some old wire and a bulb from it. So Naina took a cell out of the clock.
Oh wow, all the materials are collected at home only.
So Naina quickly arranged all the materials in the same way as she did in the school. And the bulb lighted.
Oh wow, sister.
You know, all the electronic devices in our home run on this principle.
Didi, now how we will turn off the bulb?
By removing the wire from any one terminal of the cell.
But when we have to turn off a bulb in the house, we don't need to remove any wire.
Yes, it's a matter to think about as how the wires are connected to that button. The wires are placed inside the wall and we can't even see it.
So Naina, if you want, you can put buttons in this electric circuit too to switch on and off the bulb. Such buttons are called electrical switches.
How is that, Father?
Let's try it now.
Dad cut the wire from one side in the circuit. Immediately, the bulb turned off because the flow of current stopped.
So Naina, can you remove the plastic from these two ends of the wire?
So Naina quickly removed the plastic layer. Dad took out a key from the old box and attached one end of the wire to that key.
So Naina, now connect the second part of the key to the wire.
As soon as So Naina connected the other end of the key to the wire, the bulb turned on.
Oh wow, it was very simple.
Dad, why did you use the keys to make the switch? There's a lot of stuff in this box.
Let's do one thing. Let's add different things to this power circuit and then check if the bulb lights or not. Mother picked up some items like rubber, iron nail, chalk, piece of cloth, piece of glass, etc. from the box.
So Naina and I will make a list of all these things and see which things will light the bulb.
So Naina made a list on paper.
First of all, let's try with this iron nail.
So Naina removed the key and connected the iron nail. The bulb turned on.
Father, write yes in front of the iron nail in this list. Now let's try with eraser.
On connecting the bulb with rubber, it didn't light. Nor on connecting with the piece of cloth. But on connecting with the silver spoon, it lighted up. Iron nail. It lights the bulb on. Rubber. The light bulb doesn't turn on using rubber. Cloth. Use of cloth doesn't light the bulb. Silver. Silver turns the light bulb on.
Why is it that the bulb is illuminated by some things only?
That's because some of these things are electrical conductors and some are insulators.
What is it?
When the current flows in an electric circuit, if there is any resistance in between, the flow of electricity gets disrupted and the circuit is considered incomplete. Electric conductors are materials that do not stop the flow of electricity. Rather, these substances make the flow of electricity easy, such as materials made up of metals, iron, copper, silver, etc. That's why electrical wires are made up of metals, so that electricity can flow through them.
But plastic is there on the top of the wires, right?
Yes, wires made of metals are coated with insulating materials. Insulating materials are the substances that prevent the flow of electricity. This is done to prevent people from getting electric shock on touching the wires. So, this is very important.
Yes, children, you should be very careful with electricity. Such experiments should be done only in the presence of elders. Even in home, Use electric devices only in front of elders. If carelessly handled, it can cause severe injuries.
Yes, Father. We will take care of these things.
Wow, I really enjoyed doing the experiment with you all.
Me too.
Us too.